Now, your KSBW weather forecast with Chief Meteorologist Lee Solomon.
Good evening, everybody. A little warmer today and a little bit more humidity, which certainly makes it feel warmer too, right, than the thermometer indicates. So that's part of this heat that is coming. It's not just actually hot temperatures like you would get in the Central Valley, where it's really dry and warm. 90s up there in the Santa Cruz Mountains today, so it was already pretty hot. Boulder Creek, 98, 88 in Santa Cruz. So even the coast, right, the marine layer has been mixed out. We don't have that to rely on to cool us off. 70s, Moss Landing, 90 in Corralitos. We did have a little bit of a sea breeze. Didn't help Morgan Hill much, though. 100 there, and 99 in Gilroy, 99 Hollister. The heat was on. 84 in King City. You're wondering why it was a lot cooler down there. A lot of cloud cover. Subtropical moisture coming up from the south. Mostly cloudy day there. Kept the temperature down. So even though they're under the same exact air mass as you were, let's say, in Soledad, just that cloud cover reducing the incoming solar radiation makes a difference. Mid-70s Pebble Beach today, 86 in Monterey, 80 in Seaside, 90 in Carmel Valley. So the warmth was already there. And again, there's that moisture. So if you were in Santa Cruz today, it was mostly sunny. If you were in King City, it was mostly cloudy. Again, nothing to do with the marine layer. There are no low clouds, fog, or anything like that along the coast right now. The other part of this is that this moisture is coming up not only as just some tropical moisture, but it's spinning up showers and thunderstorms. And we were really lucky today that you'll notice that most of these lightning strikes were out over the ocean this afternoon and earlier this morning. Now, had they been over land, that could have been a really big problem. Now, some of those storms were coming down with some rain, so we had the lightning and the rain. So that's always a good thing, right, because that puts a fire out as the lightning strikes. But you got to remember, bolts go off in many different directions, so the band of rain that comes down may not hit everywhere. So that's always a problem. That's what we call dry lightning. Right now, there's another batch of moisture off the coast that is headed our way. So we'll see if some of that holds together for maybe a shower or a thunderstorm overnight tonight. You can see the slug of moisture. All of this is actually leftover moisture from some tropical storms and hurricanes that were out over the Pacific. Those riding northward now, it's that time of year that we get this every once in a while. And you can see that batch again coming up from the south. Again, it may hold together enough. You can see some of it out here off to our south and east. But for the most part, it's kind of running into drier air in Northern California and drying up. Your highs today in the Central Valley were anywhere from about 100 to 116 out in Palm Springs. And that kind of heat is, again, headed into our local area tomorrow. 106 Sacramento, 106 Fresno, 107 Bakersfield. But believe me, you don't need to go that far to get into that kind of heat tomorrow. And I'll show you the temps here in just a second. Clouds coming up again. The high overcast during the afternoon through about midday tomorrow. And then it starts clearing up. You'll notice the light northwesterly wind. So we still have a little bit of sea breeze. It's not offshore flow, but it is a lot of warmth. Now, here they are, the heat alerts. We have heat advisories, including Santa Cruz Mountains over to Watsonville. And then there's a little sliver around the coast from Moss Landing down to Marina, Seaside, Monterey, and Pebble. Well, you do not have an advisory. Then you get out into Morgan Hill and Gilroy. There's your excessive heat warning. That includes the southern half of the Salinas Valley from Greenfield south. So just about most of our area under some kind of heat alert tomorrow and Saturday. 61 to 67. It's mild. It's muggy overnight with a slight chance of a shower or a thunderstorm tomorrow. I have it as an alert day at the coast with upper 70s to middle 90s. So again, even at the coast, there'll be a range 96 to 106. For our valleys and hills tomorrow, again, with the excessive heat warning, it is going to be very hot. Please take it easy out there during the day tomorrow. 80s and 90s up in the Bay Area in San Francisco, 81, 99 in San Jose tomorrow, 103 Boulder Creek, 100 Felton, 99 Scotts Valley, 94 Santa Cruz, 84 in Aptos. Looking at the temps going inland, 97 Corralitos, 105, 106 Morgan Hill, Gilroy, 102 Hollister, 104 San Juan Bautista, 97 Aromas, and then 90s, upper 90s, Gonzales, Soledad, 98 in King City, and then back to the coast with 70s and 80s throughout the Monterey Peninsula, 96 in Carmel Valley. So now you can see why the heat advisories do make sense. We'll carry those through the weekend. Heat advisories along the coast through Saturday with 80s and 90s. There isn't actually a lot of relief probably until next Wednesday, so it's going to be a while. Mid-90s to triple digits Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday for the valleys and hills. It's an extended heat wave. Take it easy. If you are working outdoors, take frequent breaks and lots of water.